Ships have to reach net zero by 2050 and GFI starts in 2027? What even is that?
That's from MEPC 83. The IMO's new plan to cut emissions just kicked in.
Shipping accounts for around 3% of global emissions. MEPC 83 is where the IMO decided to take active measures to cut down on that. They now demand all ships, big or small, cut greenhouse gases aggressively by 2050. And it's not voluntary anymore. New rules will hit starting 2027. Technical improvements, financial penalties, all rolled into one system. Let's ask Master Ishida.
Hello, I am Master Ishida from the biomass team. Well, let me explain. MEPC 83 introduces a system with two parts, a technical element and an economic element. The technical side is based on GHG fuel intensity, GFI. It's basically a score showing how much greenhouse gas a ship emits for every unit of energy it uses. The formula is as such. This formula looks complicated, but it's really just measuring one thing. How much greenhouse gas your ship emits for every unit of energy it uses. At the top here, we multiply two things together. The greenhouse gas intensity of each fuel you use, and the amount of energy you got from that fuel. At the bottom, we add up all the energy used from every fuel across the year. That's your total energy. That means it counts all emissions, not just from the ship's engine, but from producing, refining, and transporting the fuel, all the way until it's used on board. Every ship above 5,000 gross tons must meet GFI targets yearly. The targets get stricter over time, reviewed every 5 years.
Now comes the economic part. If you miss your GFI target, you pay by buying remedial units from the IMO. There are two types, depending on how much negative balance compliance has been incurred. Tier 1, smaller misses, cost $100 per ton of extra CO2. Tier 2, bigger misses, cost $380 per ton. But how is this incurred, you might ask? Let's look at the scenarios. Shipowner A got ahead early. By 2027, it's already below the target, earning surplus units every year. Shipowner B, it waited too long. It dips below the direct target. Now it has to buy Tier 1 remedial units at $100 per ton CO2, and that cost adds up fast. And C, it made no real change. Now it's breaching both Tier 1 and Tier 2 levels, and paying $380 per ton CO2 for every extra ton it emits. Now if these vessels maintain their GHG levels throughout, Vessel B slips into Tier 1 and 2 penalties by 2030, Vessel A by 2032, while Vessel C will be paying heavy fines for years. Only Vessel A will be able to offset its penalties from the surplus units it has acquired initially, but even so, it will run out if it do not improve its GFI over time. This highlights the need to act early and stay ahead.
So what can you do with surplus units?
If you earn surplus units, you can sell them once to another ship or bank them for up to 2 years.
So, if a ship starts early and beats the target now, it earns higher surplus credits and can bank them for future years. Those early movers? They'll have a serious head start.
Exactly, because once the penalties kick in, it's not just about compliance anymore. It's about cost survival.
Everyone's panicking, scrambling to buy credits and looking for cheap fuel.
That is why we need to act fast now. Tier 2 penalties aren't small. This gets expensive really quickly.
With MEPC 83, the pressure is now global. The entire shipping industry must shift toward cleaner fuels, smarter ships, and greener port infrastructure much faster than before.
A cleaner future isn't just a dream anymore. It's a course we're already charting.
A big challenge, but also a big opportunity. Let's join the journey. Comment, like, and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next voyage into the future of fuels.